it was natural at first to suppose that, like the X-rays, that they were connected with the movement of an electron. But there are certain reasons, theoretical partly, that lead us to believe that the movements of the electrons cannot produce, are not responsible for the gamma rays we observe.
The South Island town of Havelock is linked with two of New Zealand's greatest scientists. Ernest Rutherford and William Pickering both spent their childhoods in the town, and both attended Havelock Primary School. Ernest Rutherford was born near Nelson in 1871. When he was 11, Rutherford's family moved to Havelock to be nearer to the flax mill where Rutherford's father worked. After studying at Nelson College, Rutherford attended Canterbury University. He then won a scholarship to Cambridge University in England and studied radioactivity. He discovered that there were two types of radiation. Alpha radiation was a stream of positively charged helium atoms, or alpha particles. Beta radiation was a stream of negatively charged electrons. In 1898, Rutherford became a professor at McGill University in Canada. There, with a chemist called Frederick Soddy, Rutherford showed that radioactive atoms decay into lighter atoms. The men showed that each radioactive element had a half-life, the time for the number of that element's nuclei in a sample to reduce by half. This enabled Rutherford to be able to predict the approximate age of the Earth. In 1908, Rutherford was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for his investigations into the disintegration of elements and the chemistry of radioactive substances. He was the first New Zealander to be awarded the Nobel Prize. By 1911, Rutherford was Professor of Physics at Manchester University in England. Rutherford had his assistant, Hans Geiger, after which the Geiger counter is named, and his student Ernest Marsden, carry out an experiment. A thin gold sheet was bombarded with alpha particles. Most particles passed straight through the sheet, but some were deflected. An amazed Rutherford said, "It was as if you had fired a large shell at a piece of paper, and it had bounced right back and hit you." From this experiment, Rutherford deduced that almost all the mass of an atom is concentrated in a tiny positively charged nucleus that is orbited by negatively charged electrons. Later, Rutherford bombarded oxygen atoms with alpha rays, which converted oxygen atoms into nitrogen atoms. He became the first person to split the atom. In 1931, Rutherford became Baron Rutherford of Nelson. He died 6 years later, aged 66. In 1969, element number 104 in the periodic table was named Rutherfordium after him. In 1992, his portrait featured on New Zealand's new $100 banknote. Havelock's other famous scientific son, William Pickering, became a leading figure in the American space program of the 1950s and 60s. Pickering was born in Wellington in 1910, but his mother died when he was 4, so he was sent to live with his grandparents at Havelock. Most of his tertiary education was in the United States. In 1936, he gained his doctorate in physics at the California Institute of Technology, or Caltech. He was to work at the Caltech Jet Propulsion Laboratory for most of his life. Pickering became director of the laboratory in 1954 and oversaw many NASA missions to the moon. In 1958, he organized the launch of America's first ever satellite, Explorer 1. During the 1960s, NASA's Mariner spacecraft flew near Venus and took the first close-up images of Mars, a planet that Pickering believed had some form of life. The information that the Ranger 7 satellite sent back on the moon's surface enabled Pickering to assure NASA that men would be able to walk on the moon without sinking in a sea of dust. Pickering's portrait twice appeared on the cover of the influential American Time magazine. He died in 2004.